Hi everyone, my name is Olivier Jimenez and I'm a research scientist in Montpellier in southern France. And today I'm going to talk to you about the lasso to perform covariate selection in capture-recapture models. So this is joint work with Jan Renner from Newcastle University in Australia. The context of my talk is that of the is the inference about abundance and survival in of animal species. In statistical ecology, one of our objectives is to try and explain variation in this kind of demographic parameters, survival, dispersal, recruitment. And to do so, we often use capture-recapture methods that consist in capturing, marking individually, and releasing animals and trying to recapture them over time, okay? So these are basically survival models like Cox models that account for the imperfect detection of individuals or the fact that you may miss an animal in the field even though this animal was present and you missed it because it was hidden or you were busy checking your phone. The thing is that we struggle more and more with the number of covariates that may explain temporal variation in survival. The number of covariates that increases with the use of new technological developments like remote sensing methods and also GPS equipment, for example. And we struggle to the extent that we often don't know which covariates to include or not to include in the analysis. What are the issues with having many and possibly correlated covariates, like in this figure here, where you have strongly negatively correlated covariates in red here and strongly positively correlated covariates in blue here? Well, correlation generates numerical instability in the estimation of parameters. And also having many covariates in the model implies a lack of precision in these estimates and a loss of predictability when it comes to using these models to forecast things, the viability of endangered species, for example. So what do we usually do to deal with these issues? Well, there are a few things you can do. First, we think hard about the covariates we'd like to include in our analysis. And we try to think of collinearity, drop covariates that tell the same story because they are collinear, and or use functions of this correlated covariates to include them in analysis. But still, when you have many covariates, this is a nightmare for ecologists. Where to start? Okay, once you've passed this first step, then actually to select covariates, you have several approaches possible. You may use the AIC or stepwise procedures if you're a frequentist. Alternatively, you may use the deviance information criterion, stochastic search variable selection, or to name just a few, reversible jump MCMC. In this talk, we propose to explore a different approach and another avenue, and namely to shrink model parameters in order to select them, okay? To select the corresponding covariates. Okay, a little bit of a theory. Everything I'm going to explain in this talk can be found in this amazing book by Hasti and Tipshirani called Statistical Learning with Sparsity. It's a book that is actually free, like many other books by the same authors, which is awesome, I think. So it all starts with a rich regression. Rich regression with my background joke here. The rich regression, how does that work? Well, the idea is, as usually, we're going to try and maximize the likelihood in blue here. Okay, the likelihood. Novelty is that we're going to apply a constraint on the regression parameters, and we're going to penalize the magnitude of the coefficients, the betas, okay, so that they don't explode, so that they don't take huge values like it is usually the case when we have a collinearity in the explanatory covariates. Okay, here we use the L2 norm, the sum of the squared coefficient should be less than a constant, say C. And basically what it means is that the parameter estimates, the beta's hat, should be contained within a disk of radius C. Okay, so that they don't get crazy values. Okay, now to the lasso. The lasso is an acronym for least absolute shrinkage and selection operator. Why shrinkage and selection? We'll see that in a minute. You'll understand in a minute. Compared to the ridge regression, the lasso is obtained by changing the L2 norm in the constraint by the L1 norm. In other words, the constraint now is expressed under the form of the sum of the absolute value of the regression coefficients that should be less than a constant C. Let's have a look graphically to what all this means. Let's assume we have two parameters, beta 1 and beta 2. Okay. On the left, you have the lasso, and on the right, you have the ridge regression. And the likelihood in this figure is represented by, in both plots, by these elliptical contours here. So if you don't penalize the likelihood, then the solution to the optimization problem is in the center of this ellipse here, here, and here. So these are the maximum likelihood estimates for beta 1, beta 2, right? Now the constraint region for ridge regression is the disk here, okay? Remember the L2 norm? Well, for the lasso, it's the diamond here. Remember the L1 norm, right? And both methods find the first point where the elliptical contour here hits the constraint region, the blue region here, okay? And these intersections are here, the two red crosses, one here and one there, okay? If we focus on the ridge regression on the right, the solution is here for beta 1 and beta 2, okay? And now if we focus on the lasso, unlike the disk, the diamond has corners, obviously. And if the solution occurs at a corner, like it is the case in our example here, well, one of the betas or several of the betas will be zero. Like in this case, beta 1 is zero and beta two is this value here. Okay, this will rarely happens for the ridge regression, obviously. And when there are more than two parameters, the diamond has many corners, flat edges and faces, and there are many more opportunities for the estimated parameters to be zero. And we use the term sparse for a model with just a few non-zero coefficients. And passing, the lasso provides an automatic way for doing covariance selection, which is kind of a neat, I think. Now, okay, a constraint optimization like the one we've seen for the lasso or for the ridge regression is not easy to manipulate and to solve, okay? It's often more convenient to rewrite the lasso problem in the so-called Lagrangian form, which states that for some positive lambda here, the solution of the problem is the maximum of the likelihood plus a penalty on the regression parameters. Okay, so in our case, we're going to use an adaptive lasso penalty to ensure that the most important covariates, that is to say those with coefficient estimates that are further away from zero, will be penalized less, okay? And this construction, the fact that we use an adaptive method, an adaptive lasso penalty, it also enables the whole procedure to achieve what we call oracle properties, which means that asymptotically, the correct subset of coefficients and covariates, therefore, will be chosen. And the procedure has an optimal estimation rate. And in this talk, we will use the lasso with capture recapture models by expressing, by using the capture recapture likelihood here. Okay, the L is the capture recapture likelihood. So what's this likelihood? Well, we have ones and zeros as data for detection of animals or non-detection of animals at each sampling occasion. For example, animal I may be HI, 101 for detected at the first sampling occasion, missed, then recaptured at the last and third capture occasion. If you denote phi T, the survival probability between T and T plus one, sampling occasions T and T plus one, and PT, the recapture probability at T, then the contribution of animal I to likelihood to the general likelihood is this probability phi one times one minus pi p two because you missed the individual at occasion two, then times phi two and p three because you captured the individual at the third occasion, okay, and because it was alive at the last occasion, you know that it was alive during the two time intervals, so phi one and phi two. Right, in our study, we will write the time dependent survival phi t as a linear function of the covariate the x here on the logit scale. Okay, and the general likelihood, the overall likelihood, is just the product of the probability of each capture recapture history for all individuals. Okay, back to the lasso now. The problem to how to choose the penalty term lambda boils down to choosing this lambda, right? And usually we use cross-validation techniques, but the brute force approach also works pretty well, and that's what we use in this study, in this work. Here we build a grid of values for lambda. Then we repeat optimization. We feed the model with the two covariates to each value of the grid. Okay, for each value of the grid, and we pick the lambda that corresponds to the model with the lowest BIC value. Okay, this is how we pick the penalty term lambda. Right. Okay. Let's go for some simulations to validate the approach, or at least to assess the performances of the approach. We conducted a simulation study. For the sample size, we considered 15 sampling occasions with 15 new individuals marked and released at each of these 15 occasions. And detection was high, 0.9. And mean survival was around 8.8 also. And we considered two covariates, possibly explaining temporal variation in survival, X1 here, that had a negative effect on survival on the logit scale. Okay, don't forget about the logit scale. And X2 had no effect whatsoever on survival. This coefficient was zero here. Okay, and we applied the lasso on the model with these two covariates. And also we fitted four models, a model with no covariates and constant survival, another model with both covariates, and two other models with only X1 or only X2. And for each of these models, we calculated the value of AIC, and we compared these four models with AIC to determine which model was best supported by the data according to AIC, and compare that to the lasso. And we repeated this procedure 100 times. Okay, what about the results? Well, in 80% of the simulations, the lasso selected the correct model, that is the model with X1 only, which is quite good, and this result is comparable, matches the performances we got with AIC for covariate selection. We did some additional simulations by varying the detection probability, the number of covariates, the number of sampling occasions. We also include some collinearity among the covariates, and the conclusion was similar. The lasso performed pretty well, which is cool. As a case study, we considered the demography of white storks in France. These guys spend the winter in Africa, in the Sahel region to be exact, and the capture-recapture data we have span over 16 years for more than 200 individuals that were marked, okay? Also, we had measures of rainfall at weather stations in the Sahel, 10 of them to be exact. And the main objective of the study was to explore the effects of climate conditions captured by rainfall on adult survival, right? The idea being more, if it's more rainy, you have more resources in the winter and you do better the next year. Okay. In other words, which of the 10 betas corresponding to the 10 weather stations are non-zeros? Okay, here, the betas and the 10 station. Okay, if you go for a model covariate selection approach with AIC, it's not less than 2 to the power 10 candidate models that you need to consider, okay? All the possible combinations of these 10 covariates. How to do with the lesser approach? Well, the first thing to do is to pick the best value for lambda using the BIC as we've seen before in some of the previous slides. So here we have a figure, a graph of the BIC value for each model on the y-axis as a function of different values of the lasso penalty, the lambda, on the x-axis. Okay, and it appears that lambda, the lambda around 0.05 gives the lowest BIC. Okay, so this is the value of the lasso penalty that we're going to use in the analysis. Now let's have a look to this fit in another way. On the y-axis, you have the values of the regression parameters, okay, corresponding to the 10 weather stations. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And on the x-axis, you have the values of lambda on a grid, right? So each value here, it's the a model, it's a coefficient of the model, one of the 10 coefficients of the model for a given value of the lasso penalty, right? And the vertical line is the value we use for lambda. So here, it's 0.05, the one that was suggested by the BIC in the previous slide. So let's follow the path of one regression parameter, that one, for example. So as lambda increases, as the penalty increases, the coefficient is pulled to zero and equals exactly zero before the red line, okay? So it means that that one is basically zero. And now let's follow another path, like for example, this one. So we follow it as lambda, the penalty increases, and it's still non-zero once we've passed on the other side of the red line, okay? And this is the only one that is still non-zero once you've passed on the other side of the red line. What does that mean? Let's have a look to the table of parameter estimates. On the left, you have the name of the 10 weather stations, okay? And on the right, you have the corresponding beta estimates. All the parameters are estimated at zero, roughly, okay? Very, very small, except one for Kita, this station, this weather station here. And it corresponds exactly to this coefficient, the path of this coefficient here, as the penalty increases and even past this this threshold here, well, this parameter is still non-zero, okay? So this is the only one. So what does that mean? It means that all the parameters are estimated at zero, except that one. And it means that by shrinking the regression parameter estimates, we managed to select one single covariate that had a positive effect on survival, okay? And this result was similar to a result that was obtained by other colleagues who used a PCA on the rainfall variables first, and then fitted a capture-recapture model on the first principal component. In conclusion, so what we've proposed is to do a covariate selection by considering a model with all the covariates that you're interested in, then shrink the parameters corresponding to the unimportant covariates. And in practice, the cool thing is that it's not that difficult to modify existing code to implement the penalized likelihood. You just have to add the constraint, the L1 constraint. And this might make the use of Lasso easy in the future in standard pieces of software for the analysis of capture-recapture data. And the perspective, we'd like to give a Bayesian flavor to the whole thing by using the Laplace prior. And this is the object of ongoing work. Thank you very much.